Hi, my name is Kathy Corrali. I'm an instructor with SAS Education. I'd like to show you how to export SAS data into a Microsoft Excel workbook. And I'd like to show you two ways. The first way will be with a LIBNAME statement, and the second way with PROC EXPORT. The first way I'm going to show you is with the LIBNAME statement. But before I do anything, I would like to show you the Excel workbook where we're going to write out. So here's this, the Excel workbook, and notice I do have three sheets in it. I'm going to go ahead and close this. I just wanted to show you this. First, I'd like to show you how to connect to your Excel workbook with the LIBNAME statement. So I'm going to issue the LIBNAME statement, LIBNAME X, and I'm going to use the XLSX engine. And I'm going to point to the Excel workbook. Now mine is on the C drive in the demo folder, and it's called np underscore info info dot XLSX. Right, don't forget your semicolon at the end of the statement. Now, this XLSX engine is available to you in SAS 9.4M2. So in order to use this, I want to show you a statement that you can type in to show you what version of SAS that you're using. And I'll go ahead and show you that now. It's percent put, I'm using a macro statement. This is going to write this out into your SAS log. My version of SAS is, and I'm going to use an automatic macro variable called sysvlong. It's for system version and long. It just gives you a little bit more information because you need to know if this is going to work for you. So I'm going to run both of these statements. And first, I want to show you that the libref was successfully assigned as follows. And I want to show you this in the libraries. That notice there is my X library, and those are those three sheets that I showed you a little earlier. And look at this. This looks just like what we're used to seeing with any SAS library. The big difference is these are the Excel workbooks. So I'm going to go back. Oh, sorry. I want to go back into my log, actually, and show you. Here's this. My version of SAS is 9.4M6. So you need to have at least M2 in order for this to work. And if you don't, if you're not using M2 or higher, please talk to your systems administrator to upgrade your software. Or if that's not possible, you can use SAS University Edition or SAS On Demand for Academics. Now, despite their names, it's available to the independent learner as well, not just students. You don't have to be affiliated with a school in order to use that software. And that is free access for both of them. All right, so make sure you're using the right version of SAS. And now that I've connected to that workbook, I'm going to actually write SAS data out to this particular workbook. Now, also, what I wanted to mention is in order to be able to work with Excel, you know, Excel column names can have spaces in it and special characters, and well, SAS data sets can't. Our rules are 32, up to 32, start with a letter, underscore, numbers, for a grand total of 32. No special characters other than that underscore. So if you have anything in Excel that is different when you're reading and writing, you want to make sure that you turn on this option. It's called options, option valid var name equals V7. And this is going to be especially true for my SAS Enterprise Guide users. Your default is any, A-N-Y, and this is just going to make life easier for us. This will turn special characters into underscores, and then you don't have to change anything. So options, option valid var name equals V7, right? So let me run this to make sure everything is good. Actually, I'll run just this. And when I go back into my code, as I mentioned, I want to show you how you can write out to Excel. And we're going to use the data step. So data, x dot class. I'm going to name this class. And I'm going to read a SAS data set that we all have. This is a demo file, sashelp.class. So you'll be able to recreate the scene of the crime, if you will. So I'm going to set sashelp.class. And I'm in the data step. I can do whatever I want. I am going to use some conditional logic. So if, let's say, age in that data set, age is less than, say, 13, then I'm going to create a brand new variable called ageCat. It's going to be equal to a 1. Else, if age is, I'm going to say, between 13 and 15, so if age is between 13 and 15, I'll say 14. Then hcat is going to be 2, right? And then else, if age is greater than or equal to 15, then I'm going to create age cat to be 3. Okay, so creating a brand new variable as I write out to Excel. All right, so I can do all the things that I'm used to in the data step if I'd like, but I just want to go ahead and show you this. I'm going to use my run statement. And I also, if we want to write a report, you know, we can proc print data is equal to x.class, right? To show you, I can still use that Excel workbook in SAS. I just wrote out to it, and now I can use it in SAS. All right, so let's take a look. That's what I love about this LIBNAME statement. All right, so let's take a look. I'm going to create the new SAS data, or create the new Excel workbook, actually, X dots by reading, and then I'm going to write the actual proc print. So sorry about that. Let me show you. Always check your SAS log. Make sure you don't see any weird notes, any errors, no warnings. You want to make sure everything's good. And remember that library reference? Take a look. There's class. I just created this. This is now a worksheet inside the Excel workbook. And as I mentioned, because I'm actually connected to that workbook, I can still work with it within SAS as if it were a regular SAS data set. And so when I run that proc print, I have that report. But I sense a non-believer in the crowd. So what I'd like to do, I'm going to clear this libref, right? So libname x clear. So I'm just going to deassociate that library reference, right? So SAS no longer knows, right? No connection to the Excel workbook. What I'd like to do is open Excel for you, so I can show you that Excel workbook again. I showed it to you earlier, yes? And here it is. And what we're going to see now, look at that. There is the class worksheet. And I did all of this in SAS. I used the LIBNAME statement, I used a data step, I used a proc print, pure unadulterated SAS. All right, so let me go ahead and close this. Okay, I would like to show you another way that you can write out to Microsoft Excel using the LIBNAME statement. Now, I showed you how to use the data step, because we know the data step creates SAS data sets, and this was actually an Excel workbook. But what I want to show you is that a lot of procedures in SAS also create output. So I want to show you this proc sort. I'm going to issue my LIBNAME statement again. I want to make sure that this is in play. LIBNAME was successfully assigned as follows. And what I'm going to do, because most of us do this, proc sort, yes? We all need our data in sorted order. So I'm going to do proc sort data is equal to, and I'm going to use a SAS data set to sort, but I'm going to write this out to Excel. SASHelp.snacks, this is one of my favorite SAS data sets. And I'm not interested in all the columns that are in snacks. I am interested in the product name, and I'm interested in the price of these snacks. So I'm going to use this keep equals data set option and only work with these two variables. Also, I want to tell SAS in my proc sort out equals, and I'm going to write this out to a data set called x.snacks, because where is x pointing? X is actually pointing to our Excel workbook. So again, notice that the syntax has not changed at all. Out equals x.snacks, and I also want to show you the no dupe key, because I don't want to see popcorn written 18 times. I just want a data set with each of these different snacks. Now, no dupe key means I want to use, get rid of the duplicates based on whatever my key value is, or the variables that are in my by statement. So in my by statement, I'm going to use product, because I don't want the duplicate products. I just want the unique products. So what I wanted you to see is, again, I'm sorting this data, this SAS data. I'm keeping only a few columns. I'm writing out a copy into x.snacks and the no dupe key option so that I don't see the repeat offenders, if you will. All right, so now what I'd like to do is go ahead and run this. And again, we're going to see our SAS log. We want to make sure that we don't have any error messages, any weird notes, or any kind of warning. And we'll notice that the sort indicator tells us there were 35,770 observations read from the data set. But look at all these duplicates. So now my original, my SAS data set that I just wrote out to Excel has only 35 observations and 2 variables. And again, notice snacks shows up right here as a part of that Excel workbook. And again, what I'd like to do is go back into my code and show you. I can use it. It's a SAS data set. So I'm going to just, I'll just run a PROC print. Data is equal to x.snacks. I don't want to see the observation, so I'm going to use the no obs option, but I want to know how many rows I have, so I'm going to use the n statistic. I want to see the frequency. I do want to give it a nice title, so I'm going to type in yummy snacks, right, and followed by my run. All right, so again, this is treated as if it were a regular SAS data set, even though I just wrote it out to Microsoft Excel. So let me run this. And here you have it. Here is our report of all of our yummy snacks. Notice I don't have to see the duplicates of the potato chips or the pork rinds. And again, this is in the Excel workbook. And again, I would like to show you this. Not that you don't believe me, but seeing is believing. Again, I'm not the best typist. It's clear. Now what this does is this releases the Excel workbook back out into the wild, you know, if you will, because SAS actually does hold it so that it can read and write to that Excel workbook. So I want to deassociate that library reference, and then what I can do is go back into my Excel file and take a look at that workbook. So let me check this PC. Let me go into my demo file. And oops, I'm in the wrong place. Okay, sorry, let's go into demo. And I wrote this to the NP, yes. I wrote this to, and there's snacks. All right, and there's my snacks worksheet. Okay. And I do want to show you one more way that you can do this. Because you know, you may not need all this power of the data step. Like, Kathy, I don't need to create a new column. I just want to put data in Microsoft Excel. And that's fine. You can certainly do that. So what I'd like to do is show you another way. It is the PROC EXPORT. So I'd like to show you PROC EXPORT. And PROC EXPORT, data's equal to sashelp.cars. Oh, and I'd like to show you this too. In PROC EXPORT, you know, I know I made it sound like, oh, it's just gonna, you know, dump the data in, and it will, but I can still use the data set options. So I'm going to use drop equals, and I'm gonna get rid of the invoice column because I may not need this for whatever reason. So notice I've got my data set option. It's enclosed in parens right next to the data set I want it to affect. And I'm going to tell SAS outfile equals, and where I want to write this. So I'm going to use that Excel workbook, demo folder, cars.xlsx. Right, that's the name of the file that I'd like to create. All right, so I also have dbms is equal to xlsx, and I want to replace if this already exists. So I've just got some good basic code here. I'm going to take that sashelp.cars dataset, and that is a demo file. Everybody has access to this. I'm dropping the invoice column, writing it out to this Excel workbook, and replace it if it already exists. So let me run this for you. And you're going to see some notes. Right, that the export dataset has the 428 observations. This is the one. Right, was successfully created. And again, I just want to show you this in Excel. Not that you don't believe me, but I do want, seeing is believing. Let me open up Excel and we'll take a look at that new workbook that I just created. And I'm going to open other workbook. I'm going to navigate to my PC and let me click this. I'm going to go to my C drive, to my demo folder, and there it is. There's cars.xlsx, and when I open this, there's that sheet. And notice, I named that sheet, I didn't name that sheet. SAS named it the name of the SAS data set. So that data set name was cars, that's the name of the sheet. If you want to name the sheet, you can. Sheet equals, and then you can choose your name. Please remember, in SAS, SAS data set names can be 32 characters long, but in Excel it's 31. So if you do this and you let this default happen, you might see truncation if you have a long name. I typically don't have long names. I like to keep them kind of short but descript. But just remember that, just in case. I hope you found this video helpful. If you'd like more tips like this, subscribe to the channel, check out the links below, and leave us questions or comments. Thank you.